If you don't feel rested, even after 8 hours of sleep, the villains called caffeine, nicotine, and alcohol might be the cause. This is a scary video about what not to do. It reveals a horrifying truth. When you were a teenager and your parents or teachers nagged you about the dangers of alcohol and smoking, they were right all along. Not only because drugs can cause cancer, memory problems, and mess up your social life and stuff like that, but also because they affect the quality of sleep. Coffee, tea, and many soft drinks such as cola contain a substance called caffeine, which makes us feel more alert. Half the caffeine is still in the body 5 to 7 hours after we've enjoyed these drinks, making it more difficult to fall asleep. And even if we manage to fall asleep with caffeine in our system, the brain continues to battle with caffeine during sleep, reducing sleep quality. We feel less rested the next morning and have no idea why. Nicotine is another drug that disturbs our sleep. Smokers often sleep lightly, and they tend to wake up early because of nicotine withdrawal. What about alcohol? Many people find it easier to fall asleep after a drink, but the truth is that a drink doesn't make you fall asleep easier. It only removes consciousness. Alcohol is a sedative. It first sedates the prefrontal cortex of the brain, making people more sociable and impulsive. Perhaps you've noticed that people seem to loosen up and become more extroverted, and often remarkably ridiculous when drinking. Later, the alcohol begins to sedate other parts of the brain, and you begin to feel sluggish. The point is that alcohol doesn't induce natural sleep, but that we lose consciousness more easily when drinking. Alcohol also makes sleep more fragmented. We actually wake up several times during the night without noticing. Since we don't notice this, we often fail to make the connection between the tiredness we feel in the morning and the drink we had the night before. Drinking alcohol in the afternoon or evening means we're depriving ourselves of valuable dream sleep. The same can be said about today's sleeping pills. They don't induce natural sleep, but only remove consciousness. The next morning, people feel less refreshed and logically conclude that they might need more sleeping pills. That was the scary part. The good news is that there are many things you can do to improve your sleep. For instance, try to reduce your use of caffeine, nicotine, and alcohol. Put these villains behind bars, or perhaps stop visiting bars. Also, ask your healthcare provider or pharmacist if any of your medications might interfere with sleep.